Good day, students. In this clip, we're going to be going over two examples on indefinite integration using the U-substitution method. So to get started, let's take a look at the formula for integration using U-substitution. So this is a formula. So basically, the indefinite integral of a composite function f of g of x multiplied by the derivative of the inner function g prime of x dx is equal to the integral of f of u du. Okay, this can only happen where u is equal to g of x and the differential du is equal to g prime of x dx. All right, so this is a general formula for integration using U-substitution method. So in order to use U-substitution, you're going to have two functions, a composite function and another function. Now, the inner function of the composite function, if its derivative is a multiple of the other function, then you can use U-substitution. Okay? All right, so let's take a look at an example that we can make use of that. So the instructions are to evaluate the following. So the first one we're going to try out is the indefinite integral of 3x over the square root of x squared plus 3. Dx. Okay, now I want to write this integral in this form. I want to write it as a composite function and another function. Okay, so this 3 right here, I can factor that 3 out using the constant multiple rule for integrals. So I take that out, but I have the integral, and I'm going to write down the composite function first. This function right here is a rational function composed with a radical function, and you have a quadratic function right there, okay? So we're going to write this as 1 over the square root of x squared plus 3 times x dx. Now we're going to do a test to see if I can use substitution here. Let's do the test on the side. So this is the test. You're going to take the inner function here and differentiate it and see if you get a multiple of this function right here. Okay, so let's take the inner function x squared plus 3, and I'm going to differentiate it. So x squared plus 3 prime is equal to 2x. Now, is this a multiple of this function right here? Absolutely. So this is a good problem to use U substitution. All right. So let me show you the steps to make the U-substitution work here. First thing we're going to do is we're going to pick the appropriate u. All right, so the u is going to be the inner function of the composed function, what we did a test on, which is x squared plus 3. Now we're going to differentiate. If you differentiate this, we're going to have the u dx is equal to 2x. If I multiply both sides by dx, I'm going to have the u equals 2x dx. All right, this is the derivative in differential form. Now, I like to make a clean substitution of x dx, all right? But there's a 2 here, so how do I, what do I do to this equation so I can have x dx standing alone and I can substitute it with this piece? In order to accomplish that, I will have to divide both sides by 2. All right, so we're going to have du over 2, smooth it down a little bit, is equal to x dx. Now we're ready to substitute. Okay, so now let's make our substitution. It's going to be the 3 factored out times the integral of 1 over the square root of, instead of x squared plus 3 is now going to become just u, and then x dx is going to become du over 2. All right, so when you're making your substitution using U-Substitution, there are going to be two substitutions happening. The inner function will get substituted, and the other function will get substituted also. So you have this integral right here. All right, this is a much easier integral to evaluate. Let me go ahead and rewrite it so you can see that it's in fact easy to evaluate. I'm going to factor out this 2 out to the 3, so you have 3 over 2 times the integral. Now 1 over the square root of u can be written as 1 over u to the 1 half, the u. Now using the reciprocal property of exponents, I can rewrite this, the integrand, as u to the negative 1 half, du. Now compare this integral right here with this. It's completely different. This is much easier to evaluate compared to the original one, all right? So let's go ahead and find the antiderivative here. We're going to use the power rule. We recall what the power rule is. We're going to apply it here. So we have 3 over 2 times the exponent. You add 1 half to the exponent. I'm sorry, you add 1 to the exponent and divide by what you got, okay? So that's negative 1 half plus 1. And then we don't forget the plus c component. Let's go ahead and simplify this. This becomes 3 halves. And then u to the negative 1 half is positive 1 half. And then it's going to be u to the 1 half over the same story at the bottom, 1 half plus c. And then if we simplify further, we're going to have 3 root u plus c. So are we done? The answer is absolutely not. If you notice that the original function is in terms of x, but our answer is u, so we need to resolve that discrepancy. How are we going to do that? Well, we declared u to be x squared plus 3 earlier, and the goal was to enable us to integrate. Now that we're done integrating, we're now going to replace u to its original value. All right, so if we want to do that, our final answer now will be 3 times the square root of the real value of u, which is x squared plus 3 plus c. Okay, so this right here is the antiderivative of the original problem that we did. So is our answer right or wrong? Well, let's do a check. Let's check. We have to make sure that our answer is in fact correct, okay? So how are we going to check if this is the antiderivative of the original problem? Well, we're going to do the inverse procedure, which is differentiation. So if I differentiate this result I got and I end up with the original question, then I'm confident that my result is correct. So let's go ahead and differentiate for our check. dx, the derivative of 3 times the square root of x squared plus 3 plus c. We can write this as 3 times x squared plus 3 plus raised to the 1 half. Okay, so this entire thing prime. Okay, now we're going to do term by term differentiation here. So I'm going to apply the chain rule to this piece right here. This is a u. So if I differentiate, I'm going to factor out the 3. If I differentiate this, using the power rule, holding this fixed, is going to be 1 half times x squared plus 3. And then you subtract 1 from the power, which will give you negative 1 half. Now using the chain rule times the derivative of u, which is x squared plus 3, and that's 2x. Plus, if you differentiate this constant, what do you get? You get 0. Okay, now let's simplify further. This 2 and this 2 divide out. And then using the reciprocal property of exponents, I can rewrite this as 3x over the square root of x squared plus 3. Okay, so is this the integrand that we started with? Let's go up. Absolutely is. This is the integrand of the original problem. So we're confident that our answer is correct. All right, let's take a look at question number two. So for number two, we are to evaluate the integral, the indefinite integral of 2x squared plus 1 divided by 2x to the third plus 3x plus 1 dx. Okay, so is this a candidate for U-substitution, integration using U-substitution? Now to see if that's a possibility, we're going to separate these two functions, differentiate the inner of the composite function, and see if we get the other function or a multiple of the other function, right? So how about we write this like this, the integral of 1 over 2x to the third plus 3x plus 1 times the other function is 2x squared plus 1 dx. Now let's go ahead and do the test. I'm going to do the test over here. So the question is, if I differentiate the inner function of this function right here, will I get this or its multiple? So this is a composition of a cubic and a rational function. So the rational first and then the cubic. All right, so let's differentiate this inner function, the cubic, 2x to the third plus 3x plus 1 prime. What's the derivative of that? If you differentiate this function, you end up with 6x plus 3. Not, I'm sorry, 6x squared plus 3. Okay, so 3 times 2 is 6, minus 1 is 2, and then you differentiate this, you have 3. Now, can I express this as a multiple of 2x squared plus 1? Well, let's see. What if I factor out the GCF here, which is 3? What am I left with? I'm left with 2x plus 1. 2x squared plus 1, which is excellent because that's exactly what this is. So it passes the test for U-substitution, so that's what we're going to use here. All right? So let's go and show the formal steps. So for this one, we're going to call u 2x to the third plus 3x plus 1. And I'm going to differentiate both sides. I'm going to use differentiate it and express it using differential. So I'll have du equals 6x squared plus 3 dx. You notice in the other example I did du dx and then multiplied. So I skipped that step. I just differentiated using differentials, all right? So this is what it's going to look like. Now, here we have 2x squared plus 1 dx. So let's do the factorization. We're going to factor out 3, and we'll be left with 2x squared plus 1 dx. This 2x squared plus 1 dx doesn't have any constant in front, and this has a 3 in front. So how do we resolve this issue? Well, we have to divide both sides by 3. So we have that other piece standing alone, okay? So if I do that, I'm gonna have du over 3 equals 2x squared plus 1 dx. And that's exactly what this piece is, okay? Now we're ready to do our u substitution. We do our u substitution, this problem becomes the integral from 1 over u, this entire inner function becomes u, and then 2x squared plus 1 dx becomes du over 3. Please do not forget this 3 right here because it's important. Now to integrate this, I'm going to factor out the constant, which is 1 third. So we have 1 third times the integral of 1 over u du. Okay, and the integral of that is 1 third times the natural logarithm of the absolute value of u plus c. All right, so that's the antiderivative. So the question is, are we done? And the answer is absolutely not. So if you look at this problem, the original problem is in terms of x, and this is u, so we have to substitute what we called u initially so that we can have our final result, all right? So we're going to have 1 third times the natural logarithm of, instead of u, we're going to use the real value of u, which is 2x to the third plus 3x plus 1 plus c. And that's your final result. Okay? All right, let's go ahead and do a check by differentiation to see if our answer is in fact correct. So the question is, if I differentiate this, if I find ddx of 1 third from the natural logarithm of the absolute value of 2x to the third plus 3x plus 1 plus c, do I end up with the integrand that I had earlier? Okay. All right, so let's go ahead and do the differentiation. Now, if I differentiate this, I can factor out the 1 third. Okay, and then if I differentiate this situation right here, when you differentiate the natural logarithm of a value, you end up with 1 over that value. So the derivative of the natural log of this entire expression using the chain rule is going to be 1 over that expression. You do not need the absolute value, so 1 over 2x to the third plus 3x plus 1. There's no need for the absolute value here because there's no constraint on the domain for the sine of this expression in the rational function, okay? And then that is the derivative of the outer function, and then we'll multiply that by the derivative of u, okay? Notice that this is ln u, so you do the derivative of ln times the derivative of u, which is simply 6x squared plus 3, okay? 6x squared plus 3. Okay, so that's the derivative. And then if we simplify this, we can factor out 3 from the top. Let's scroll this down a little bit. Factor out a 3 times x squared plus 1. Let's try that again. So it's 3 times 2x squared plus 1. 2x squared plus 1 divided by 3 times 2x to the third plus 3x plus 1. Okay, what do you notice happening here? These 3's cancel out, and you are left with 2x squared plus 1 divided by 2x to the third plus 3x plus 1. Now, is this the value of the integrand that we started with? Let's go ahead and check. 2x squared plus 1 over 2x to the third plus 3x plus 1. It absolutely is. So we're confident that our answer is in fact correct. Okay? So that's that. So thanks so much for taking the time to watch this presentation. You can feel free to subscribe to our channel. And please post a comment to let us know what you think about this presentation. More clips can be found on mypsf.com/calculus. Thanks again for watching, and have a wonderful day.